Let us look at the next chapter, that is number systems. So this is the introduction part. Now you might have learnt in your earlier classes that how a number line looks like and how to represent it. Now this is the figure 1.1 which is showing the number line. Now there is a zero here, the positive integers are on the right side and the negative integers are on the left side. Now imagine that you are standing at the point zero here and you're walking towards the positive direction. Now you can see that there are many numbers lying and the list can go on. It extends till infinity on the right side and till negative infinity on the left side. Now you start walking from this point and you're moving towards the positive direction. You take a bag and you start collecting the counting numbers, namely 1, 2, 3, so on, and the list can go on. And you put it in a bag. Now this, you can see that it is tagged as N. So the natural numbers, the definition is given as, the natural numbers include all positive integers from 1 till infinity and are also used for counting purposes. So these are the numbers starting from 1 till infinity that you can use for counting purposes, and they are positive integers. Remember that natural number does not include 0. So it starts with 1, 2, 3, 4, so on till infinity. And this is denoted by, this collection is denoted by N. Imagine that you have gone to a certain extent and you come back to the point here and you collect this zero and put it in the same bag. Now this bag will be tagged as W, which represents whole numbers. The definition for whole numbers is, whole numbers are numbers without fractions and it is a collection of positive integers and zero. So you had positive integers and you're adding the zero to the same bag. So this collection will be now called as whole numbers. It is denoted by W and it starts with 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, so on till infinity. We have come to this point, okay? And now when we look ahead, we can see that there are many negative numbers. Now, we take all of these negative numbers and put it into the bag. And now this new collection will be called as integers and denoted as Z. So the definition for integers is, integer is defined as a number that does not include the fractional parts. So you can see integers are the whole numbers. You have the whole numbers including negative numbers, including negative numbers. So it doesn't have fractional part and it is denoted by Z. Now we have seen that in earlier cases natural numbers were denoted by N and whole numbers were denoted by W. Why the integers are denoted as Z? Z comes from the German word Zahlen, which means to count. Now let us look into the next type of collection. So you have the same bag in which you, for now you have the whole numbers and the negative numbers. That is, it is a collection of integers for now. Now when you see the number line, there are some more numbers that are remaining. These numbers are of the form, as you can see here, 1 by 2, 17 by 981, minus 2005 by 2006, minus 12 by 13, minus 6 by 7. All these numbers you are putting into the same bag, and now this new collection will be denoted as Q and called as rational numbers. So the definition for rational numbers is, a number R is called a rational number if it can be written in the form P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0. That is, when it is written in the form of P by Q, the denominator should not be equal to 0 because any number A, when divided by 0, becomes undefined. Okay, so now examples for rational number can be any positive number divided by any other number. For example, you can see here 17 by 981, 1 by 2, etc. It can also be negative, that is minus 12 by 13, minus 2005 by 2006. Also, there is an example here, minus 25 by 1, where P is equal to minus 25, that is the numerator, and the denominator Q is equal to 1. So, it is evident that the rational numbers contain the natural numbers, whole numbers, and integers. So, it contains all of the collections that we have learned earlier. Now, there is a concept called as equivalent rational numbers or fractions. So, we can see that 1 by 2 is equal to 2 by 4, is equal to 10 by 20, is equal to 25 by 50, is equal to 47 by 94, and so on. So, we understand that the rational numbers do not have unique representation in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0. So, in this example, we can see 1 by 2 can be represented in many other ways. However, when we say that P by Q is a rational number, or we want to represent P by Q on the number line, we mean that P and Q have no common factors other than 1. That is, P and Q are coprime. And also, the denominator Q should not be equal to 0. So, on the number line, among infinitely many fractions equivalent to 1 by 2, we will choose 1 by 2 to represent them all.